Good morning, students. Today we are going to see exercise number 8.1 part 2. Okay, already we have completed up to question number 6. So today we are going to start from question number 7. Okay, so the 7th question is, calculate the mean of the following distribution using assumed mean method. Okay. So they said specifically you can use the assumed mean method. Okay. So first we should know what is the formula for assumed mean method. So the assumed mean method means assumed mean method. Okay. So what formula we are going to use? X bar is equal to A plus summation FD divided by summation F. Okay. Here D is nothing but X minus A. Okay. Check. So the question is, என்ன கொடுத்திருக்காங்க? Class interval கொடுத்திருக்காங்க. Then frequency is given. Okay. So from that we are going to find the table. Okay. So first you can make a table. Okay. So first one is a class interval. Okay. First one is a class interval. Then second one, frequency. Third one, mid value. Mid value is nothing but x. Okay, so here there is directly they are not giving the x value. Okay, only the class interval is given. So from that we are going to find the mid value. Then d is equal to x minus a. Then next one, FD. Okay, so you can make a table. So here, how to find the x mid value? So we know that the frequency is, the class interval is 0 to 10. Okay. So already I told you, if you want to find the mid value of x means, you should add the lower limit and the upper limit, then divided by 2. Okay. So here the lower limit is 0, then the upper limit is 10. So if you add, you will get 10. 10 by 2, you will get 5. So mid value is 5. So what is the frequency? 5. The first two columns is given in the question. So 0 to 10, 10 to 20, then 10 to 20, then 20 to 30, 30 to 40, then 40 to 50. Okay. Then the frequency is 7, 15, 28, then 8. Okay. So already I told you mid value. So for 0 plus 10 means the mid value is 5. So 10 plus 10 to 20 means 10 plus 20 you will get 30. 30 by 2 you will get 15. So 10, 10 add it. So what do you get here? 25, then 35, then 45. Okay, so now we are going to choose the assumed mean. Assumed mean is nothing but here a. Okay, so we want to choose the a value. So a value you choose for x values le, middle value choose for here we have a 5 terms. Okay, in x we have a 5 terms. If you have a odd number of terms means you can choose a middle value. Okay. X values la odd number of terms na, middle value choose panikla. Suppose even number of terms in 6 terms abina, equal 3 terms are split. So we can take a 4th term. Okay, wow. Even number of terms in the 4th term half was split panikla, first term. first half விட்டுட்டு செகண்ட் ஹாஃப் செகண்ட் ஹாஃப்ல இருக்க ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டம் எடுத்துக்கலாம் சப்போஸ் உங்களுக்கு நீ எதை கூட எடுத்துக்கலாம் முன்னாடி உள்ள ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஹாஃப்ல உள்ள லாஸ்ட் வேல்யூ கூட எடுத்துக்கலாம் நோ ப்ராப்ளம் ஓகேவா இப்ப நான் வந்து என்ன பண்ணிருக்கேன் ஆட் நம்பர் ஆஃப் டம்ஸ் இருக்கிறதுனால மிடில் வேல்யூ சூஸ் பண்ணிக்கிட்டேன் ஓகே சோ ஹியர் d is equal to x minus 25 ஓகேவா சரி சோ நவ வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு find x minus 25 here x is the value of 5 okay so what do you get 5 minus 25 you will get minus 20 then here you will get minus 10 here 20 minus 25 minus 25 you will get 0 here plus 10 here plus 20 okay so this is the d value now we are going to add here this is frequency no that is f frequency is f so now we are going to add the f column and the d column these two columns we are going to add okay va f u d e motta enna panna porom we are going to add the two columns ay multiply panni enna pannanum f d la namba find out pannanum so 5 into minus 20 5 into minus 20 what you get 100 so minus 100 then 7 into minus 10 you will get minus 70 Then 0 with any number. So here only you are going to do the mistakes. 0 into 15. 0 into 15 you will get 0. Okay. Sometimes they some students they do 15. Okay. Well, 0 into any value you will get 0. Then next one 28 into 10 you will get 280. Then next one 160. Okay. This is 8 into 20 you will get 160. So in this formula. Assumed mean formula what we need a value need then summation fd and the summation f that means the f columns no second column that you have to add the values then fd column last column also you have to find the total value okay so what you get summation f this is your summation f so if you add all these values you will get 63 Okay, ma. See, 5 plus 7, 12, 12 plus 15, 27, 27 plus 8, 35, 35 plus 20, 55, 55 plus 8, 63. Okay, so the summation f is equal to 63. Then here, if you add summation fd, what do you get? If you add the positive numbers, you will get 440 minus 170 you will get plus 270 this is summation fd okay so now we are going to apply the values in the given formula okay so assume to mean x bar is equal to a plus summation fd divided by summation f okay we know that a is the value of Assumed mean. This is the a value. A value is here what? 25. A is under 25. So you can apply here. A is equal to 25 plus summation FD. FD is the total what? 270. So 270 divided by summation F. So F is equal to 63. F is equal to 63. So what do you get? So you should divide the 270 by 63. 270 and 63 all divide pannu. Okay. So 4 times pannu abina you will get 250. 252. Then if you subtract you will get 180. Then next 2 times means you will get 126. If you subtract you will get 554. Then you can add up 0, 540. Then next one 8 times means you will get 504 then if you subtract you will get 36 so 360 5 times means you will get 315 so what about the remaining 45 so 3 digits after the decimal 3 digits is enough okay so you can convert it so 25 plus 4.285 it will be converted means 4.29. So what do you get? 25 plus 4.29. 25 is a whole number. 4.29 means the 4 should be in the whole part. 4.29. So what do you get? 29.29. Okay. So the 4 on the other side put add panniradinga. So inge varanum. Okay. So you will get 29.29. This is the arithmetic mean. Okay. That's all. Okay. So your 7th problem over. Then next one. Problem number 8. Okay. The question is, find the arithmetic mean of the following data using the step deviation method. Okay. The method is step deviation method. Okay. So the age is given and the number of person is given. Okay. So in this method also we are using the A value. Okay. Check. So we can make a table. Before that we should write a formula for step deviation. Okay. Question number 8. So step deviation method. Step deviation method. So the formula is x bar is equal to a plus summation fd by summation f into c. Okay, here d is nothing but x minus a by c. Okay, so what we need, a need, d need, and c. C is the class interval and f is already given. So we have to make a table. Okay, so what is that? Age, first one. Age is given, that is 15 to 19. So x, then in this method we have a interval, no, 15 to 19. Then 20 to 24. Okay, then 25 to 29, then 30 to 34, then 35 to 39. Then 40 to 44. Okay. Here we are going to find the mean. Okay, va. So in the interval la namakku continuous interval illa. Okay, va. So continuous interval illa appna namba vandha vandu discontinuous ah irukku nu artham. So namu continuous ah maathrom, but inge namakku adu use aagadhu. Okay, va. Namba vandha மோர் கண்டுபிடிக்கும் போது அந்த எல் பிளஸ் அப்படிங்கிற ஒரு ஃபார்முலாவில் எல் பிளஸ் வரும். அப்போ அந்த லோயர் லிமிட் யூஸ் பண்ணுவோம். அப்போ வந்து இங்கே கண்டிப்பாக நமக்கு எப்படி இருக்கணும்னா அது வந்து கண்டினியூஸ் இன்டர்வலாக இருக்கணும். நமக்கு இந்த இடத்துல தேவையில்ல. ஸோ நான் என்ன பண்ணிக்கிறேன் அப்படின்னா டைரெக்டாக அப்படியே வச்சு மிட் வேல்யூ கண்டுபிடிச்சிக்கிறேன். ஆனால் இங்கே நமக்கு மோர் கண்டுபிடிக்கும் போது கண்டிப்பாக அது என்னவா மாற்றணும் அப்படின்னா கண்டினியூஸ் இன்டர்வலாக மாற்றணும். ஓகே. ஸோ நீங்கள் இந்த இடத்துல கூட நீங்கள் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணிகிட்டே கூட போடுங்க. ஏன்னா நமக்கு அப்போ தான் வந்து அந்த பழக்கம் வரும். ஓகேவா? ஸோ நீங்கள் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணிகிட்டே கூட போடுங்க. என்ன பண்ணலாம் அப்படின்னா இங்கே லோயர் லிமிட் வந்து 15 இருக்கு. ஓகேவா? அப்பர் லிமிட் 19. பட் நமக்கு வந்து எப்படி இருக்கணும்னா 19ல தான் திரும்ப ஸ்டார்ட் ஆகணும். பட் ஆனால் இங்கே வந்து எப்படி இருக்கு, 20ல ஸ்டார்ட் ஆகுது. ஸோ என்ன பண்ணலாம் அப்படின்னா லோயர் லிமிட்ல 0.5 சப்ராக்ட் பண்ணும். ஏன் அப்படின்னா இங்கே 19க்கும் 20க்கும் இல்லை இடையிலோட டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் எவ்வளோ அப்படின்னா 1. ஸோ அந்த 1 2 டிவைட் பண்ணும் அப்படின்னா எனக்கு 0.5 கிடைக்கும். ஸோ அதனால என்ன பண்ணிக்கிறேன், லோயர் லிமிட்ல 0.5 சப்ராக்ட் பண்ணிட்டு அப்பர் லிமிட்ல 0.5 நான் ஆட் பண்ணிக்கிறேன். ஓகேவா? சோ அப்ப என்ன கிடைக்குங்க நீங்க நம்ம யூஸ் பண்ண மாட்டோம் பட் இருந்தாலும் நீங்க அந்த ப்ரொசீஜர் தெரிஞ்சுக்கோங்க ஏன் அப்படின்னா அப்பதான் வந்து அதே ரொட்டீனா நீங்க வந்து என்ன பண்ணுவீங்க அப்படின்னா மோர் கண்டுபிடிக்கும் போது நீங்க செய்வீங்க ஆனா இங்க வந்து தேவையில்ல பட் இருந்தாலும் நீங்க போடணும் ஓகேவா சோ வாட் யூ கெட் ஹியர் 14.5 to 19.5 ஓகேவா So next 20 minus 0.5 means 19.5 to 24.5 okay then next one 24.5 to 29.5 then 29.5 to 34.5 then next one 34.5 to 39.5 okay then next one 39.5 to 44.5 okay so the next one mid value x okay so namba inge mid value find out panna enna solirken அப்பர் லிமிட்டே லோயர் லிமிட்டையும் ஆட் பண்ணி 2 டிவைட் பண்ணுது ஸோ ரெண்டுத்துல என்ன வேணும் எடுத்துக்கோங்க இங்கே இப்போ 15 plus 19 வாட் யூ கெட் 15 plus 19 யூ வில் கெட் 34 by 2 யூ கெட் இந்த லிமிட்ஸ் எடுத்துக்கோங்க ஓகேவா ஸோ 15 plus 19 யூ வில் கெட் 34 யூ வில் கெட் 20 34 20 34 okay so you can take any interval 15 plus 19 you will get 34 34 divided by 2 you will get 17 okay then 20 plus 24 you will get 44 44 divided by 2 you will get 22 so it If you know that 17 here 5 added okay so 22 so next you will get 27 next 32 next 37 then 42 okay ma so like this you have to add it then next you have to find the frequency number of persons okay in questions is given number of persons f okay so f is equal to what is our f 4 then 20 next one 38 next 24 then 10 then 9 okay so this is the f value then d value d is nothing but already I told you d is equal to x minus a divided by c okay d is equal to x minus a divided by c here you can choose this x value okay this is our x value This is our x value. You can choose a value. A value means here we have a even number of terms. Already I told you. Even number of terms means you can choose the second of first term. Okay. நீங்க 27 choose பண்ணிக்கலாம். Answer same அதான் வரும். No problem. Six terms இருக்கறதால 3 terms ஆ split பண்ணிட்டு அடுத்த terms நான் 32 எடுத்துக்கிறேன். 27 எடுத்தா answer same அதான் வரும். That is your wish. Okay. Then next one. So what is c c ங்கிறது இங்க என்ன பண்ணனும் இந்த கிளாஸ் இன்டர்வல்ல நம்ம டிவைட் பண்றோம் அப்படிங்கிறது ஓகேவா சோ இப்ப கிளாஸ் இன்டர்வல் இதுக்கு இதுக்கு இடையில உள்ள டிஃபரன்ஸ் எவ்வளவு அப்படிங்கறத நம்ம பார்க்கணும் டிஃபரன்ஸ் பாத்தீங்க அப்படினா இங்க என்ன இருக்கு நமக்கு டிஃபரன்ஸ் வந்து 5 னு வரும் ஓகேவா ஏன் அப்படினா 14.5 ல இருந்து 19.5 எடுத்தீங்க அப்படினா உங்களுக்கு என்ன ஆன்சர் you will get 5 limit okay wow. so 19.5 length 19.5 minus 14.5 na you will get 5 so the class interval is 5 okay so ipo enna pannalam x minus a divided by c x irudhu inga enadhu 17 minus 32 17 minus 32 inga ikkuda potukenga 17 minus 32 divided by 5 what do you get 17 minus 32 means you will get minus 15 na minus 15. Okay. Okay, minus 15. Minus 15 by 5 means you will get minus 3. Okay. Then next one. 22 minus 32 by 5. So you will get 10. 10 by 2 means you will get minus 2. Then 27 minus 32 by 5, you will get minus 5. So you will get minus 1. So minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. So what do you get? Like this you have to get 0, 1, 2. Okay. So 32 minus 32 by 5 is equal to 0. Then next one, 37 minus 32 by 5 is equal to plus 5 by 5 means you will get 1. Then 42 minus 32 by 5. So 10 by 5 you will get 2. Okay. So next. So next one, FD column. Okay. So FD means F into D. So here F is equal to 4. Then D is equal to minus 3. So what do you get? 4 into minus 3? Minus 12. 20 into minus 2? 20 into minus 2, you will get minus 40. So the next one, minus 38. Then 0. Then 10. Then 18. So if you add, you will get minus 62. Summation FD is equal to minus 62. Add panni paarenga. Negative numbers first add panni ke apdina 40 minus 40 plus 38 minus 38 means minus 78 plus if you add minus 12 means 90 minus 28 you will get minus 62. Okay, then next. You should add F, summation F. Summation F is equal to, if you add F column, you will get summation F is equal to 105. Okay, so if you add this column, you will get 105. So now we are going to apply in the formula. Okay, what are the values need? A need summation FD and the summation F into C. C is the class interval. Okay. So you can write it x bar is equal to a plus summation fb by summation f into c. Okay. So x bar is equal to, here a is the value of 32. A is the value 32. So 32 plus summation fb is minus 62 divided by summation f is equal to 105. Okay. Into c is equal to what? Here 5. So you can cancel it. So what do you get? Here you will get 21. Okay. So the remaining answer minus 62. 62 are 21 all divide padu. Okay. So you will get 2 times. 2 times means 42. Remaining you will get 20. Then if you add 0, you will get 9 times 21. That is 189. Then if you subtract, you will get 11. Okay. So then 11 means if you add 0, you will get 5 times. 5 times means 105. Remaining 5. Okay. So 2.95. 2. Then another digit, if you add 0, you will get 2 times, okay. So 2 times 42. So 2.952, it is negative because minus 62. Therefore, x bar is equal to 32 minus 2.952, okay. So what do you get? You want to subtract, okay, 32, 0, 0, 0, then 2.952, 2.952. Okay. So if you subtract here 10, 9, 9, here 1. Okay. So what do you get? 4. 4, 0. Then 11. 11 means 9. Here you will get 2. So 29.048. That is equal to, you can take it as 29.05. Okay. This is our x bar. Therefore, the arithmetic mean. Is equal to 29.05. Okay, that's all. So your x is 8.1 over. Okay, then next we are going to see about the median. Okay, that is x is 8.2 introduction. Next we are going to see about the median. Okay, this is exercise 8.2 part 1. Okay, so in this exercise we are going to study about the median. So, in the first exercise, we have studied about mean. In this exercise, we are going to study about the median. Okay. So, median na. So, median is the value which occupies the middle position. Which occupies the middle position when all the observations are arranged in ascending or descending order. It is a positional average. Median is another. It is a positional average. Median is a positional average. It is very important. It is a 1 mark. Okay. So median is the positional average. So they are giving which is the positional average. Mean, median, mode like this they will give. So you should choose the answer. Okay. So the positional average is median. Okay. So median grade which occupies the middle position. Nadupara and the value of the slow median the solo. Okay. Then in this we have a three types of formulas. Okay. Suppose only x is given. Only x is given means first you should arrange the ascending order in ascending order or descending order. Only x is given means you should find number of terms, okay. Number of terms n, okay. Number of terms small n, only x given now, okay. So, first you should arrange in the ascending order or descending order. Then, the median is, we have two formulas. If it is a number of terms is odd, number of terms are odd or which now, apa enna varum n plus 1 by 2th term. Okay. And the value kadaiyadhu anga values la irukra adha ethanaala irukra and the terms la nama solluvom if n is odd. If n is odd means you can use n plus 1 by 2th term. Okay. Then suppose if n is even you can take n by 2 average of n by 2th term and n by 2 plus 1th term. Okay. If n is even, number of terms even, you can use this formula. Okay. So, if only x means number of terms n is given. So, you have to use If n is odd, you can use n plus 1 by 1 x, n plus 1 by 2 the term. If n is even, average of n by 2 the term and n by 2 plus 1 the term. Okay. Then next one, this is the first one. Then second one. If x and f is given, if x and f is given means the summation f denotes capital N. Summation f, that means f add values, f or values that add panna namak kadikum illaya and the n undu enna nu solluvom summation n nu sorry summation f undu n nu solluvom seriya seri ipo idha vechittu adhe formula dhaan but enna appadina namakku inga capital N varu okay va so n odd ah irundhuchuna if n odd means the median is n plus 1 by 2 value. Okay. Tooth observation. Okay. N by 2, n plus 1 by 2 observation. அந்த வேல்யூஸ் எடுக்க மாட்டோம் அதுக்கு கரஸ்பாண்டிங்கா இருக்கிற எக்ஸ் வேல்யூ எடுப்போம் ஓகேவா n ல என்ன இருக்கோ அதுக்கு கரஸ்பாண்டிங்கா இருக்கிற எக்ஸ் ல உள்ள வேல்யூஸ் நம்ம எடுப்போம் ஓகேவா சப்போஸ் சாரி இங்க n கேப்பிட்டல் if n is even you can take the same thing what is the average of okay average means it's divided by 2 no the same one okay so average of n by 2th observation and n by 2 plus 1th observation okay this is if it is n is even suppose if it is a grouped data if it is a grouped data class intervals குடுத்திருந்தாங்க அப்படினா grouped dataல எப்படி நம்ம median find out பண்றது grouped dataவா இருந்துச்சு அப்படினா the median is median is equal to l plus n by 2 minus m divided by f into c okay so this in this where l is equal to only if you know the formula you can't able to do the sum okay first we should know what are the symbols is given agar mostly given symbols la enna meaning irudha namba find out பண்ணு so l is equal to lower limit of the median class lower limit of the median class lower limit of the median class then f is equal to frequency of the median class then c is equal to width of the width that is class interval limit okay and the limit oda width of the median class then m is equal to cumulative frequency of the class of the class preceding preceding na adukku munadi irukadhu okay va preceding the median class preceding the median class preceding the median class okay sums work out பண்ணும்போது உங்களுக்கு ஈஸியா இருக்கும் ஓகேவா so cumulative frequency of the median class and n already I told you n is equal to summation f n is equal to summation f okay